Here we see the Church of Wetzes. That's in the Netherlands, in the province of Friesland. It's a very old church. It was built in the 12th century. It doesn't have a tower anymore because the tower was taken away because it was very, very bad shape. They still have a bell there. You know, when there's a funeral, they use it. Yeah. And you see always that there is always a path around the church and about and around the graveyard. When somebody was taken to his grave, then they first walk around this path. They walk around this path and then they bury the body later. This is also built on a hill, actually, on a man-made hill. That's a lot higher than the surroundings, because in early years still the sea came here in winter. And all the land overflooded with water. The walls of the church are very thick, a meter or 3 feet. It was built and rebuilt many times. There are all numbers on the wall of the church. It does say from which row the graves are in. And you see also different stones that are used. The very bigger stones, you see the bricks, they are actually called Friesian bricks. They're used before the smaller ones you see here. And then you see the bigger ones. It was renovated with smaller stones because you didn't have the old ones anymore. You see the surroundings of Wetzes. Wetzes is a very small village, actually. Maybe about 15 houses and some farms. It's a farm area in the north of the Netherlands. You see all those testimonies also on the stones, yeah, in the hope of eternal life, does it say. The people lived around the church, you know, and they didn't like to be buried also very close to the church. Here you see have the 7, 8, also the rows of the graves again. He's still on that path around the church. See some different here. You also see a testimony of somebody who rests here till the day of resurrection. That's what they believed. That's what our forefathers believed. Also here we find it in the Church of Witches. Here we are at Hoge Beinden. Very small village again in the province of Friesland. It's a beautiful spring day. A lot of this man-made hill is dug away. It was very fertile, so they used it. So they used it as fertilizer for the fields. But the house and the church remained, so also the ground underneath it. In the far you see the dike, where the sea is behind. This church was built around the year 1000, so it's more than 1000 years old. Also we see here the farming area. Around the church. You open the gate. We see the path around the church and the graveyard. The church also is built again from different types of bricks. And it has a tower, what they call a saddle duck tower. I don't know what it is in English. This is the church is on the highest hill. Highest step, it's about 9 meters higher than sea level. See also that there are some openings that were probably doors. The brick too now. You see some old graves, died in 1896. Here also you see the different size of bricks again. In the small places where also had could have been a window. Probably when it was a Roman Catholic, they would have a statue there, a small statue of Mary or so. So we see the tower, it's pretty high. So the church is seen from the surroundings because it's a lot higher than the rest of the surrounding area, what is pretty flat, flat earth here, no hills. You see the door, you see also the bigger size of the bricks. And there, the smaller sizes. Here again, we see on the north side of the church only one window. In the old days, you had to pay taxes, also churches. The more windows you had, the more taxes you paid. You always can walk around it. There's always a path around the church. So you see here also the Friesian language. Taonwantinken. Means in memory of my dear husband, father and grandfather. So this was actually the church of Hege Bijntum.